समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने नमोवत् व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण्विदधाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्री चिद्घन गणेशाय नमो। यम सुकर नित्य सुख प्रकाशम व्यापक नाम रूप अधिष्ठान बुद्धि 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 हृदय पारम सर्व वेदांत वेद्यम प्रत्येक परमा तदेव नमस्तो निष्ठामति। सो वी लुक्ड एट व्हाट इज रसास्वाद द लास्ट ऑब्स्टेकल टू समाधि। Now this was interpreted by Sadhu as saying the Ananda, which is Avantara Ananda, not Paramananda, not Atmananda, that occurs due to the obstacles going away, cessation of the obstacles. So Vikshepa Rupa Sarpa Nivritya in the example, before the wealth is attained, protected by the cobra, that cobra going away itself is sukha, sukha janaka. Similarly here, when samadhi is about to take place, when the vikshepas go away, that time what happens? So vikshepa rupa, the sarpa in the example, but vikshepa in the exemplified, when the vikshepa goes away, that time itself one gets lot of ananda. That is called as rasaswada. Partaking that will block the swarupananda in samadhi. Athava, the other interpretation for rasaswada is savikalpaka samadhi anushtanuttaram nirvikalpaka samadhi prasidhyate. Savikalpaka samadhu triputi pratiyate. Ataeva sopadiko ayam samadhi iti vakshate. Nirvikalpaka samadhu tu triputyabhavad eva nirupadikananda jayate. So savikalpaka samadhi has triputi, whereas nirvikalpa does not have triputi. So savikalpaka is also called as sopadika. There is an upadhi of the triputi in the samadhi. During the savikalpaka samadhi also there is ananda. Partaking that as rasaswada, called as rasaswada, will also block the nirvikalpaka samadhi. Nirupadika ananda, where there is no upadhi in ananda. Upadhi of triputi, of course antakkarana will be there, otherwise you cannot have anubhava of ananda. Itham savikalpaka samadhya arambha dashayam sopadika savikalpaka samadhya ananda aparihariyataya anubhuyate. So in this ananda there is no choice, and who wants a choice in ananda? Everyone wants ananda. So given a choice also, people will choose ananda. Therefore the warning, it is unavoidable that ananda would not occur. However, we should be alert and not get trapped. Stay the course. Even in that triputi alone being there, don't stop there, is the idea there. स एव रसास्वाद इत्युच्यते तस्मात् विक्षेप निवृत्ति जन्यानंद अनुभवो वा सविकल्पक समाध्य आनंद अनुभवो वा रसास्वाद इत्युच्यते। सो द टू डिस्क्रिप्शंस ऑफ रसास्वाद आर वन आफ्टर द निवृत्ति ऑफ ऑल द विक्षेपास व्हिच आर ऑब्स्टेकल्स टू समाधि। अदर इज व्हेन द समाधि सविकल्पक समाधि इज टेकिंग प्लेस, दैट टाइम द आनंद इज कॉल्ड एज रसास्वाद। Both will block, both have the potential to block nirvikalpaka samadhi if one gets addicted or starts enjoying and stays there itself. Sadvividaha api rasasvadaha nirvikalpaka samadhi nirvikalpaka samadhija paramananda anubhava virohitvad vigno bhavati. This last vigna to nirvikalpaka samadhi janyananda. Ja is here. Jata janyananda. Born out of nirvikalpaka samadhi. Atasa parityajya eva. So one should drop the lesser ananda for paramananda. Evam nirvikalpaka samadhau sabhavat. Evam nirvikalpaka samadhau sabhavat vigna chaturtayam savadhanataya parihrityaha samadhijam paramanandam anubhavati sa eva jivan muktaha. So one who has jivan mukti ananda, thank you, sambhavat. So there's a typo, there are quite a few typos on this page, I think. So this is sambhavat. Thanks, Surubhi Amma. So evam nirvikalpaka samadhau sambhavat. So bhavati shatranta with a sampratya there. Not shatranta. Sambhavat. Yeah, maybe shatranta there. So nirvikalpaka samadhau, maybe. There is a typo there as well. It's sambhavat. Vigna chaturtayam sambhavat. Okay. So, vigna chaturtayam sambhavat. So, it will go with vigna chaturtayam. Evam, nirvikalpaka samadhau vigna chaturtayam sambhavat. Shatranta neuter. Savadhanataya parihrityaha samadhijam paramanandam anubhavati saiva jivan muktaha. So, I don't want to spend much time there. I wanted to speed up this chapter. I am still unable to. So anyway, I'll let that be. So the Vigna Chaturtaya which was discussed, they should be dealt with. Savadhanataya, being alert, being focused, and knowing about them, how to counter them, one should counter them. So Samadhija, the Paramananda, which is Samadhija, Paramanandam Anubhavati. One has Anubhava of Paramananda, Brahmananda, Swarupananda, that person is called as Jivan Mukta. Sa eva Jivan Mukta, eva kara is there. So Jivan Mukta is a term used generally to say anyone who has dridatara jnana, samshaya rahita jnana. However, the person who is indulging in karma will have less and less ananda. Therefore, sannyasa is prescribed. Thereby, the meaning of Jivan Mukta, Jivan Eva Mukta, because Mukti is Ananda Swarupa and Ananda is lesser in one who indulges in circumstantially in whatever one finds oneself even after Jnanotpatti. Therefore, that person's Ananda being less, he is not a Jivan Mukta, he is Mukta, alright. He has eligibility in Videha Mukti. When the Prarabdha is over, his body falls off, it disintegrates, including the Sukshma Sharira, and then he is one with Brahma. Otherwise, while being alive, Jivan Eva, Jivan is also Shatranta there, Jivan Eva Muktaha, Jivan San Muktaha. So being alive itself, he is mukta. That definition doesn't apply because mukta means ananda. Anandavan. Paramanandavan muktaha. If you look at that, then jivan mukta is a restricted term to one who has paramananda, which is samadhija. This samadhija has to be understood in another manner also, because nirvikalpaka samadhi ananda may be there for some rare cases where one is with open eyes, like Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi. They may or may not know the surrounding. They may not even react to the surrounding even with the eyes open, because this samadhi ananda is being partaken of. Or it draws the person, it resolves the person where the indriyas are resolved while the golakas are open. Anyway, that's an aside, just to say samadhi can be nirvikalpaka samadhi state in the waking state itself, where others see the person as waking, this is called as sahaja samadhi as well. Jnaninah bahya pravruttir na sambhavati tyakshepa. Now there is a question by the Purva Pakshi. You talk about Jivan Mukta as one who is in samadhi, or one who partakes of samadhi ja ananda. Whether he is in samadhi or not is another matter. That is also technicality here. What has been said here is samadhijam paramanandam anubhavati saiva jivan mukta. It is not specifically mentioned as to this ananda is during samadhi itself. One may be able to tap onto the same ananda, recalling the samadhi, and that itself takes the person into that state without actually practicing dharana dhyana samadhi. Rare cases. Now the Purva Pakshi says, after having elaborately explained all this, what you have missed is that jnani does not have other vyavahara at all. Bahya pravritti is not there, so how do you differentiate a jnani and jivan mukta? Jnani is a jivan mukta, why? Because bahya pravritti abhava is there. Bahya pravritti abhavat. Jnaninah chittam niralambanataya na tishtati prarabdha balat samadhir utthit. Anubhava, one is convinced without a doubt, one can never be confused that there is any other ananda. Then that smriti being there, one can have samadhi jananda at other times also. So prarabdha bala samadhir uttitasya api samadhi anubhuta paramananda smriti syadeva. There is a prarabdha bala to have sukha, but there is a prarabdha bala to even be in samsara. Tasmad utthana samaye api jnaninah chittam na niralambam bhavati. Now this jnani who has come out of samadhi, his chitta is not hanging, waiting to depend on some other vishaya. It is already dependent on the paramananda, swarupananda, which one experiences in samadhi. So bhijanadi pravruttirapi bhijanadi pravruttirapi jnanina kevalam prarabdha karma janya eva. So whatever pravritti is there, any activity which is there, that is prarabdha karma janya. Just like the smriti is of samadhi, smriti, the recollection of samadhi is also prarabdha janya. One may hold on to it. Similarly, every other karma or every other vyavahara, so actually bhojanadi, I'm still a little sleepy again. So bhojanadi, not bhijanadi. Bhijanadi makes no sense. I was thinking, what is it? I was saying, going to say it was a typo. So bhojanadi. So bhojanadi. Here it is bhojanadi. So here it is bhojanadi. Here it is bhijanadi. This is not right. So I got shifted here. So I am as sleepy to not even know the difference that this word is here, this word is here. So interchangeable in my mind. So sorry about that. Bhojanadi pravruttirapi jnanina kevalam prarabdha karma janya eva. The bhojanadi pravrutti also. So sometimes when you are more alert, you read through the typos. Sometimes the words don't make sense. You get confused. You isn't sense me. So bhojanadi vyavahara, bhojanadi pravrutti itself is due to prarabdha karma. Sharira sthiti matra karma. And why bhojanadi? Because jnani sannyasi is limited to bhikshatana ityadi. It was mentioned earlier. Now adipadena all karmas need not necessarily be bhikshatana adi. It can be any karma. If a person is a grahastha jnani, then adipadena all other grahastha karmas are also what? Prarabdha karma janya eva. तथापि भोजनादि व्यवहारेषु दुःखमस्ति इति ज्ञात्वा एव ज्ञानी प्रवर्तते. नाउ ज्ञानी नोज प्रारब्धाय समर्पितं स्वपुः. As Bhagavatpadacharya says, one gives into prarabdha because fighting prarabdha is also a great effort. Prarabdha does not bother the person. If there is something to be done, you do it and get away from it. Or get away unto next prarabdha. If you start countering prarabdha with a lot of effort, then samsara drags you back in. Therefore, jnani knows that this is due. Lot of people have anubhava. You try to fight prarabdha, prarabdha fights back. It is due to you. It is, you have earned it. How can you deny it? The only way to counter prarabdha is with fresh karma. If you add fresh karma, then what is the use of jnana? You take care of the circumstance with the least effort. That is the way out of, for a jnani. For the most part. So tatapi bhojanadi vyavaharishu dukkham asti iti jnatva eva jnani pravartate. He knows that as soon as he starts doing something, it is dukkha rupa. Why? Because paramananda is there. When you are doing something, that paramananda cannot stay as it is. You cannot have the mind focused on both at the same time. You cannot have a resolved mind acting out. So at least during that activity, the mind is definitely not resolved. So it is going to have dukkha. What is this dukkha? Just like we saw, the Vikshepa Nivritti Sukha, similarly the Paramananda Nivritti, Samadhi Nivritti or Samadhi Smriti Nivritti itself is Dukkha Rupa. Just the flip side of it. Vikshepa Nivritti itself can be Sukha. Similarly, the Samadhi Paramananda Nivritti will be what? It has to be Dukkha. Compared to Paramananda. So that level of Dukkha has to be accepted. Although the jnani does not think himself as dukkhi, he knows that karma itself is dukkha rupa. Vyavahara is dukkha rupa. Bhojanadi pravrittirapi asya samadhi sushupti virodhitvena sharira nirvahakataya pratita kheda rupa eva bhavati. So sharira nirvahakataya pratita kheda rupa eva bhavati pravrittihi. The bhojanadi pravritti will be dukkha rupa, kheda rupa. Kheda is another way to say dukkha rupa, an obstacle. Sharira nirvahakataya. Because you have to maintain the sharira has to be carried as long as there is prarabdha, thereby samadhi shushupti viroditvena. As opposed to, being opposed to samadhi and shushupti ananda, Sushupti is mentioned for everyone to understand how if you have to wake up and work when you are in Sushupti Avastha and someone wakes you up, you have to work. If there is something very important, the mind does not get dragged in. There is adrenaline flow. But otherwise, when the adrenaline rush goes away, you feel, oh, I was better off asleep. Because of ananda. Similarly, samadhi ananda will be opposed by the pravritti. Tasya, tasya api. So here also looks like there is an api. Tasya api, tatra adhika pravritti jayate. Kintu, or na maybe, I am not sure. Tasya na tatra adhika pravritti, maybe na. So tatra na tatra adhika, na right, okay, yeah. Thank you. So tasya na tatra adhika pravrittir jayate. Because tasya jnani na. Adhika pravrittir na jayate makes more sense than api. So evam aneki acharya imam eva paksham svikurvanti. Again svikurvanti. Who is missing there? Jivan mukta ananda api bahya pravrittav na jayate. So evam aneki acharya. many Vedanta Acharyas imam eva paksham svikurvanti. They say that, yes, prarabdha vasha jnani acts. Does he have ananda then at that point of time? No. So the common sense is agreed with jivan mukta ananda api bahya pravruttu na jayate. Jivan mukti ananda cannot stay with bahya pravruti. Thereby, at that point of time, you cannot say there is ananda. Kintu nivruttau eva jayate. Only when the pravruti becomes nivruti or pravruti ceases and thereby there is nivruti, what happens? Swabhava is to stay in oneself. Therefore, the mind has the swabhava of resolving when there is no activity to be done. So, the mind is trained enough that when there is nothing else to do, it is not an ideal, an idle mind is devil's workshop, as the Westerners would say. The jnani's mind is a Brahma workshop. It remains in Brahmananda. Atah jivan mukta mukti sukhayinah. Again typo there. Jnaninah bahya pravrittireva nasyat. Thereby, even when one is under the influence of prarabdha, that time jivan mukta mukti ananda, paramananda may not be there, but the aropa is what? One who has sukha, jivan mukti sukha, that kind of jnani will not have bahya pravrutti itself. Avarteshu krita shankayaha samadhanam. Towards these objections, there is an answer given. Before that, there was a set of here. Vigna Chatushtayam was mentioned on that. There is a long tippana. Just let's go through it quickly. Akhanda chit swarupa avagahi chitta vrittir nidra rupolaya vignaha prathamaha. So nidra is prathama, we have seen in the mula. Prathama vigna to samadhi. Tasya vishyantaralambana rupa vikshepa vignaha dvitiyaha. When there is tendency to go towards other vishyas, that is a vikshepa rupa dvitiya vigna. लय विक्षेपयोर अभावेपि स्तब्धता रूप कषाय विघ्नस्थितिः. स्तब्धता विच रिजल्ट्स इन आफ्टर अवॉइडिंग लय निद्रा रूप लय एंड विक्षेप विच इज इंडल्जेंस और लेटिंग द इंद्रियाज रन फ्री टुवर्ड्स विषयाज इंक्लूडिंग मन ऑल्सो. सो इंक्लूडिंग मन, सो दैट इज द्वितीय एंड लय इज विघ्न इज प्रथम विघ्न. If one tries to counter these, then there can be stabdi bhava. That stabdi bhava is kashaya rupa tritiya vignaha. Dukkha nivritti rupa anandena savikalpaka samadhyanandena va trupta chitta vritti rupa rasaswada vignas chaturtha. We have seen this today itself. We close in the opening of the class. So rasaswada has been explained twice, which is also the fourth vigna to paramananda रूप समाधि दे. विषयानंदः सातिश्यानंदत्वात् सांकुशः. ज्ञानिनः आनंदस्तु ब्रह्मानंद भिन्न अभिन्नत्वात् निरंकुशः. सो सांकुश एंड निरंकुशः. विषयानंद इज व्हाट इट इज लिमिटेड आनंद. देयरफॉर इट इज दैट इटसेल्फ इज अंकुश, दैट इज इट टेंट देयर. वेयर एज द फ्लॉ isn't there in Brahmananda, it is not tainted. Rajju jnana sarpa bhrantir yatha badhyate tatha adhisthana brahma jnanena ahankara adi jagat bhrantihi badhyate. Just like through Rajju jnana the Rajju sarpa badhya becomes badhya, similarly the bhranti is badhya, which is jagat rupa. Jagat is bhranti. How? Knowing the adhisthana, which is brahma atma. Tathapi yatha sarpajnana janya bhayakampadi kalantare nivartate tatha prarabdha karma janya bhogopi prarabdha nashanantaram eva nivartate. Even after rajju sarpa is negated with Rajju Jnana, still the earlier Bhaya which has come up out because of Sarpa, Rajju Sarpa, not knowing it is Rajju Sarpa, it is Sarpa, meaning there is no sarpa, there is only rajju. Without that knowledge, what happens? Person may have fear. And one may even have shiver due to fear. There may be kampana also, sharira kampana. Oh God, there is no Bhagavan. Look at this. There is a sarpa. What do I do? So I'm scared. Within one may be thinking that, how do I save myself from this? There is kampana. One may not be able to run away also. One may get stuck there. The shock itself does not let a person think that one has to run away. So, even after knowing that it is Rajju, the person may be sweating, there may be Kampana, there may be increased heart rate, the fear is there, all these continue for a bit. Similarly, even after Brahmajnana, Prarabdhavashat, there may be karma pending. तथा प्रारब्ध कर्म जन्य भोगोपि प्रारब्ध नाशानंतरम् एव निवर्तते. इट वोंट गो. प्रारब्ध विल बी देयर जस्ट लाइक कंपना इज देयर. भीति इज देयर फॉर अ पर्सन हु नोज दैट देयर इज नो सर्प. सिमिलरली वन हु नोज दैट देयर इज नथिंग कॉल्ड एज जगत, बट स्टिल प्रारब्ध कर्म इज देयर विच कीप्स द शरीर टिकिंग. देयरफॉर प्रारब्ध नाशानंतरम् एव प्रारब्ध कर्म जन्य भोग निवर्तते. मंदांधकारस्था रज्जुः पुनरपि सर्पात्मना यथा प्रतीयते तथा भोगकाले मनुष्यः अहम् इत्यादि प्रतीतिः. अहम् इत्यादि प्रतीति. अहम् इति इज समासः देयर. सो अहम् इत्यादि प्रतीतिः ज्ञानिनोपि कदाचित् जायेत. नाउ दिस इज इम्पोर्टेंट. व्हेन अ पर्सन नोज दैट देयर इज नो सर्प, अदर ग्रंथास से दैट after knowing sarpa as rajju, meaning there is no sarpa, there is only rajju, one will not have fear. Of course there may be a little time, but one will definitely not get confused that it is sarpa again. That is not true though. Maybe at that moment, yes. Or why maybe? At that moment definitely one will not think that is sarpa again once one knows it as rajju pratyakshataya. However, again one passes the same road, maybe not the next day, maybe a week later, a month later, when the memory has gone. Or memory is still there. Even then what happens is that there is no reason for Sarpa to not be there. Next time when he is going through the path, the Sarpa can be there. So each time it is not necessary that it will all be Rajju Sarpa. There can be a bhranti in the same spot again as to there being sarpa. And this time also it may not be sarpa. One of these times it can be sarpa also. That possibility being there, one may see the sarpa again in the same place, although one knows that there was rajju there. So one is careful. Similarly, jnani, although he knows that there is no prapancha, what happens? Tatha bhogakale manushyaha aham ityadi pratitihi. Manushyo aham ityadi pratiti. So manushyo aham iti. So I am a manushya. Although one knows that the manushya sharira is a part of jagat which isn't there. So I cannot be a manushya when the sharira itself is mithya. How can I be a manushya? Although one knows it, still what happens? Manushyaham mithi pratiti syat. Jayeta. It is possible for a jnani kadachit. So even if there is sthirata in that jnani also, there can be a thought that I am manushya at times. उपादान भूत अज्ञान निवृत्त्यनंतरम अपि प्रपंच प्रतीतिर् ज्ञानिनो मुक्तेषु न्यायेन भवत्येव. जस्ट लाइक अ शॉर्ट एरो. दि उपादान भूत अज्ञान निवृत्त्यनंतरम अपि. ऑल्दो दि उपादान हैज बीन निगेटेड कॉग्निटिवली, स्टिल देयर इज अ लेश व्हिच मे लीड टू कार्य सच एज अहम मनुष्यः. इत्यादि. सो दि मुक्तेषु न्याय विनो द शॉर्ट एरो. मुक्त इशू इज अ शॉर्ट एरो. मुक्त इज शॉर्ट एंड इशू इज एन एरो. सो मुक्तेषु न्यायेन एंड दैट इज एक्सप्लेन वी हैव सीन दिस मेनी टाइम्स. सो यथा व्याघ्र बुद्ध्युत्सृष्टः बाणः पश्चात् गोमतौ उत्पन्नायामपि न स्वयं प्रशांत वेगो भवति गच्छन्नेव वर्तते अन्ते च वेगक्षयादेव प्रशाम्यति एवं हस्तविसृष्ट बाणस्थानीयं प्रारब्धं कर्मापि फलदानाय प्रवृत्तं फलक्षयादेव प्रशाम्यति. सो इवन इफ द एरो इज शॉर्ट लुकिंग एट अ टाइगर इफ द टाइगर रन्स अवे एंड बिहाइंड दैट देयर इज योर ओन कैटल is there, still what happens? The bana which has been shot won't stop. When will it stop? Vegakshayadeva. When the momentum ceases to be, whether or not it hits the target is irrelevant. Even after hitting the target or not hitting the target, or hitting a non-target or not hitting the non-target, meaning the target that you aimed at, what happens is that if the momentum is there, it will continue to go further also. Similarly, comparable is prarabdha, which is already shot out. As long as it has vega, it will be there. What is that vega? Phaladana. As long as phala has not been given, it will continue to be there. Phalakshayadeva prashamyati nanyataha. Not otherwise. Atastavat kalam tatprayukta prapancha pratiti rapi utpannayam api brahmamatau anuvartyeta eva. So when the prarabdha bhoga is due to a jnani, then what will happen? Prapancha pratiti can be there. In the brahmamati also, one who has brahmamati, but still, this is a bahuri, brahma, brahmani, mati asya, buddhi asya, or brahma buddhi asya, we can say that also, but we'll keep it as brahmani. Saptami is better, dvitiya is restricted, or we can say brahma eva iti mati asya. That is the idea there conveyed there. What happens? Still prapancha will be there at that moment. It can be there, it will be there in many cases. Thereby, when will it go away? So it will go away only on prarabdha bhoga. Okay, so much for the tippana. Back to moola. Yasya jnanina prarabdham bhiksha bhojanadi phalamatra hetu tasya bhiksha bhojanadi matre pravruttir jayate. Yasya tu prarabdham itopyadika bhoga hetu tasya adhike api vyavahare pravruttir bhavati eva. So there are two categories of jnanis, broadly if you put them. One who is a sannyasi or sannyasi vat sannyasi, who withdraws from all other activities except for maintaining one's own sharira. There, the pravritti into bhikshatana ityadi, bhojana, all these are only prarabdha janya. Similarly, for the other category where there is a lot of other bhoga due, can be punya janya or papa janya, sukha dukha, if it is there, then that is also prarabdha janya. When prarabdha bhoga due is more, then the person will be in the second category. Won't focus only on bhikshatana ityadi. Thereby, what will happen? Ananda will be adhika for the sannyasi category of jnani, whereas ananda will be less for non-sannyasi category jnani. Jivan mukta is a term, although loosely used for both, we have seen jivan mukta is a term better used for one who has ananda. For the most part. So that is discussed here. Atrakshepa nanu yasya prarabdham bhiksha bhojana matra hetuhu tasyeva jnanam jayeta. Now there is a viewpoint saying that how can you say that jnani has other karma also? In fact, that person is not a jnani. This is the akshepa, which is not true. So one whose prarabdha has lessened to such an extent that he has consumed all other punya papa janya bhoga and only bhiksha tanadi remains, meaning only maintaining the sharira is left. That kind of prarabdha, when it is due to a person, only then that person becomes a jnani. This is the akshepa. Other way to look at it. यस्य पुनः प्रारब्धम अधिक्य अधिक व्यापार हेतु नैव तस्य ज्ञानं जायेत. ज्ञान इटसेल्फ विल नॉट बी पॉसिबल इफ अ पर्सन हैज मोर प्रारब्ध. दिस इज द आक्षेप. तस्मात् भिक्षा भोजनादि व्यापारात् अधिक व्यापारो न ज्ञानिनो युज्यते. यस्य अधिक व्यापारे प्रवृत्तिरस्ति स नैव स्याद् ज्ञानी इति. सो वेरी सिंपल, यू नो, इफ द पर्सन हैज मोर प्रारब्ध, jnana won't be possible, therefore jnanotpatti not being possible, that person is not a jnani. So you can make out, if there is adhika vyapara, then pravritti being there, he is not a jnani. Very simple. In fact, this person does not need the study of second chapter because he has gone beyond that. Second chapter of Gita, where jnani lakshana is mentioned, he also does the same thing that the others do. One cannot differentiate really. Only one knows whether one is a jnani or not. Others can infer, but there is no idam ittham. Samadhanam. Niyam sambhavati shanka. Iyam shanka na sambhavati. Why so? You are an astika, says the Siddhanti to the Purvapakshi. Yataha Shri Rama Krishna Yajnavalkya Janakadeha Jnanina Uchyante. Do you agree or don't you agree? Shastra talks about Shri Rama, Avatara, Krishna, Avatara Purusha, who are jnanis. May not be jnanis per se, may not show that they are jnanis, or may not be jnanis also till they became jnanis. Meaning, they were not born jnanis. If you assume that also, it is fine. If you assume that they were born jnanis, that is also fine. But before the avatar ended, do you agree that they were jnanis? At least then they were jnanis towards the end of the avatar, because both were taught in their gurukulas, they were taught in their rajyas, they were taught by acharyas, Vasishtha Muni, Vishwamitra. But we see Vasishtha Ramayana, where, you know, Adhyatma Ramayana, we have Muktika Upanishad, where Rama is talked about. So some people, on an aside, some people have this thinking, you know, Rama is an avatara in some yuga. How can Muktika Upanishad being Vedas, Apaurushya, talk about some Purusha? So before Rama avatara, was that Upanishad not there? All these questions may come in and may belittle the Upanishads also. These Upanishads do not manifest themselves in all yugas in the same manner. There may be slight change. That is one answer. The other can be across kalpas. Third can be, answer is that they are so, Upanishads are so, it is not that Rama did something and then the Upanishad talks about it. The Upanishad talks about it, Rama ends up doing it. So there is no kala badha in Vedas. So we should not lose shraddha just because, you know, some people are talked about, some avataras are talked about, which have already taken place in a particular yuga. Anyway, that's an aside. Now this Purvapakshi is being asked, do you agree that Shri Rama, when, you know, in Vasishtha, Yoga Vasishtha. Yoga Vasishtha is a teaching given to Rama by Vasishtha Muni. So there, it is jnana, it is for the most part Drishti Srishti Vada. So if you look at it, Shri Rama was a jnani. Krishna, who is Gita Acharya, who gave jnana to Arjuna, was he a jnani? At least then you have to agree that he was a jnani. It is not an ajnani teaching an ajnani. Thereby, Shri Rama, who went to Vanavasa, at that time you may say that he was doing only Bhojanadi. But it is not only Bhojanadi. He fought with Ravana. Now, at that time, let's say, hypothetically, he was not Ajnani. He was not Jnani. He was an Ajnani. Let's assume that hypothetically. Says the Siddhanta, the Puro Pakshi, you have to picturize it. Now, after Vasishtha taught him, that time at least he had Jnana. Was he, do you hear anywhere in Ramayana, even in Uttar Ramayana, that Bhagavan Rama took to Sannyasa? No, there is no such story. He ruled as a king, Ayodhya Pati Rama, therefore Rama Rajya is talked about. He was a Jnani and still ruling. Janaka also similarly. You don't have any mention of Janaka taking to Sannyasa for different reasons. Adipadena, there are others also. Yajnavalkya is very famous in Brihadaranyaka. He took Sannyasa. But there is also a time when he had not taken Sannyasa. In fact, the talk, the discussion in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad is when he was not a sannyasi. That time he was teaching Janaka. He argued in the Janaka court. He debated in the Janaka's court. And later he, in later stage, he talked to his two wives and said that I am going to take sannyasa. So these are the examples given. Jnaninah uchyante. They are all jnanis. Teshu cha sabhayam vijayena ghana sangraha vyavahare. Yajnavalkasya, sorry, dhana sangraha, this is not ghana, there is a typo here, this is not gha, this is dha. So, dhana sangraha vyavahare, we have seen this earlier. What did Yajnavalkya do when Janaka announced that I will gift 1,000 cows? 1,000 cows itself is a big deal, but not only 1,000 cows. You know, unbecoming of a king of the order of Janaka. So, he said, 1,000 cows adorned with gold ornaments. Those kind of gifts, that kind of a gift, it's a single gift. I will give to one person who wins this debate on Atma. Atma Charcha, basically, Jnana. That time, so the hero, our hero of the story is Bhagavan Yajnavalkya. He asked his shishyas to take away the cows before the debate. Why? Dhana sangraha. That vyavahara is dhana sangraha vyavahara. He wants the wealth. Even before debating, because he already had that kind of an ego, he knew that I know it all. He was a jnani and convinced that he was a jnani. He was convinced that not that he was a jnani, convinced that he was Brahma. However, dhana sangraha was still there. So, is an example given by Sadhu here to saying Sabhayam Vijayena, even pre-Vijaya, in fact. After that he won over again as in he showed that he is deserving of the gift. When people asked him why are you taking it, he says no, I have won over even without debating. It is just that I need the cows more than you. So he just made that statement. But we all know that dhana sangraha is being taking place and it is ego there. Some kind of ego is inferred, at least by the onlooker. Tatha rajya paripalanadi vyapare janakasya cha pravritti kathita. Janaka went ahead and ruled over the kingdom. Apicha vasishtadi granthesu anekesham jnaninam vyavaharu jnana prakara kathyate. So we see in Yoga Vasishta, that is Vasishtadi. Vasishtadi Grantha is Yoga Vasishta, ityadi. We see Jnani's behavior unmatta pishachavat. There is no rule per se. Jnani will be in this manner. That is why Bhagavan Krishna does not answer when he says, you know, Stita Prajnyasya ka bhasha ityadi. Same bhasha as yours, what bhasha? So if you want to look at lingas, there may be there, but they are not idam ittam. Nana prakaraha vyavaharaha kathyate jnaninam. Tasma jnanina pravruttava nivruttava naivasti niyamaha. There is no particular rule as to what jnani should do, because jnani is one who has mithyatva nishchaya complete. So he cannot chalk out line saying that this should be done, this should not be done. There is nothing to do, nothing to not do. There is no choice being made there per se. यद्यपि याज्ञवल्क्य सभायां जयं लब्ध्वा पश्चात् विद्वत् सन्यास रूपां निवृत्तिं दधे प्रवृत्तौ च नाना प्रकारा दुःख हेतु भूता दोषा कथिताः तथापि याज्ञवल्क्यस्य विद्वत् सन्यासात् प्राक् ज्ञानाभावोक्तिर् न युज्यते. इफ वन सेज दैट बिफोर ही टुक संन्यास याज्ञवल्क्य वाज एन अज्ञानी, दैट्स नॉट राइट. Why? The Hetu is given in Jivan Mukti Viveka very nicely. Bhagavan Vidyaranacharya says to the Purva Pakshi who brings about this question as to Yajnavalkya was not a jnani because we see so much of ego and greed in this Sabha, Janaka Sabha. He says that is not right. If you say he didn't have Aparoksha Jnana, that is not right. Why? He says because we are jnanis. भगवान विद्यारण्याचार्य सेज आई एम अ ज्ञानी, आई एम ज्ञानी, आई हैव अपरोक्ष ज्ञान. ही अनाउंसेस दैट ही सेज आई हैव अपरोक्ष ज्ञान. हाउ डू आई हैव अपरोक्ष ज्ञान? बाय स्टडीइंग याज्ञवल्क्य. याज्ञवल्क्य इज अ टीचर इन द बृहदारण्यक उपनिषद. सो इनडायरेक्टली इफ यू लुक एट इट ही टॉट मी एज वेल इन संप्रदाय. And I have jnana, aparoksha jnana. His jnana cannot be paroksha, it has to be aparoksha. Anumana Siddha here. Once Aparoksha Jnana is Anubhava Siddha, and since I have Aparoksha Jnana, my Guru Yajnavalkya had Aparoksha Jnana. This is how it is established in Jivan Mukti Viveka. Then he says, even before sannyasa, Jnana Bhav Yukti Na Yujyate. Therefore, you cannot say that there is no Jnana before sannyasa. Before Vidvat Sanyasa. So Dukkha Hetu may be there. He wanted Dhana, and because of their not having Dhana, he may have Dukkha. That is possible. That is not denied. Jnanam Pragapi Asi Deva. Aparoksha Jnanam. By Jnanam here is Aparoksha Jnanam. Earlier also it was there. Jivan Mukti Sukham Paran Na Tena Praptam. He didn't have Jivan Mukti Sukha. Naiva Shasti, then he says that with Dhana and all that, there is no possibility of getting this Ananda, Jivan Mukti Ananda. Tasma Jivan Mukti Sukha Vaptaye Sarva Swasangraha Parityagam Akarot. So whatever wealth he had, he said that I'll divide in. He had two wives. He said, I will divide this in both. So as a joke, some say, you know, that is the Dukkha. He had two wives. Anyway. So, just a lighter note, that is the Dukkha, as people would say, who are always complaining about married life. Yajnavalkyasya prarabdham kinchit kalam adhika bhoga hetu rasit. What was Yajnavalkyas prarabdha now? If you look at it, pre-sanyasa and post-sanyasa, Yajnavalkyasya prarabdham kinchit kalam adhika bhoga hetu rasit. There was lot of bhoga due. Thousands of cows with gold, lot of dhana, lot of shishyas, lot of fame in Janaka's court, over and over and over again. The fame to be written in history as a great acharya. That was there, kinchit kalam. Then when that prarabdha due, which is adhika bhoga hetu, that kind of prarabdha, when it goes away, paschat swalpa bhoga hetu rasi bhikshatanadi, only little bhoga was left in his prarabdha, that's when he took to sannyasa. Tasmat prathamam yajnavalkyasya vina eva aruchim bhogadikyam. He didn't have ruchi in that. Vina eva, so he didn't have aruchi, vina eva aruchi. If you have to infer, since he expresses, I need this dhana, so ruchi was there. So, vina eva aruchim, bhogadikhyam, paschad atyanta aruchya. Then, there was atyanta aruchi. That's why he said that, with all this dhana that I've accumulated, there cannot be any ananda. He tried it out. Because it was due in in prarabdha. So vina eva aruchi here does not mean that he had ruchi. That's why it is explained as vina eva aruchim. It is not that he didn't have ghrana for, you know, ghrana, need not say ghrana, but he did not have anything against accumulating wealth even after jnana. Oh, let you know, it is a resource, let it be there. So there are many who say that you cannot live without dhana in today's age, especially in today's age when bhikshatana is definitely out of the place. There are no agraharas, one cannot go for bhiksha anywhere. So ashramas have been set up. All ashramas are not suited. They won't even give place to all sannyasis. They may not give place to a sannyasi for more than 3 days, 4 days, a week, a month. After that, what is a sannyasi supposed to do? Unless there is Shishya Varga which is going to take care, today sannyasi has no possibility of surviving per se unless there is some money held on to. So there is no aruchi towards dhana. You hold on to your dhana, you accumulate it also, there is nothing wrong after jnanotpatti. This was the thinking even for Yajnavalkya there. It is not that he had greed. Greed is an inference by others. But in his mind, he says, I don't mind having wealth. It is a resource, the more the merrier. It is not giving me sukha per se. He already knew that. But then it makes my life easy. It makes the life easy for my Shishya Varga. Therefore, more the merrier. That is the aruchi here, not ruchi per se. So, vinayava aruchim bhogadikyam abhut. Then, sannyasa. After sannyasa, paschad sannyasa anantaram, atyanta aruchya, there was lot of aruchi. Not sannyasa anantaram, towards sannyasa. That is the reason for sannyasa. Sarva bhoga tyagascha abhut. He gave up everything. Janakasya, in the case of Janaka, however, there was never less prarabdha bhoga. There was always more. He was due to be an emperor, a king. Through and through, that was his prarabdha. Janakasya prarabdham tu amaranam rajya paripalanadi rupa vishesha bhogahetu rasit. Tasma tasya bhogatyagaha na bhut kadachidapi. He, Janaka, never gave up the court, the kingship, because that was his prarabdha. It is not that he was not jnani. Na api, na api aruchi. He bhogeshu sanjata. He never had aruchi. He says, what is wrong? I am a kshatriya. I am ruling well. This praja needs me. They don't want me to step down. All my relatives and friends or family members want me to continue. I have a healthy life. I am strong enough. What is wrong in my continuing as a king? So there is no aruchi towards any bhoga. All bhogas, as a grihastha, as a kshatriya, as a king, as an emperor, all that he had, he was okay with. He didn't have aruchi towards it. Not that he had greed. Okay, so there is a talk of what is sannyasa here. Vidhina sarva karma asanga karma sanga. So vidhina sarva karma sanga parityagi. Should not be karma sanga, should be karma sanga. Vidhina sarva karma sanga parityagi sannyasi. I don't think this a is due there. Sacha hamsa paramhamsa bhedad dvividha. There is a typo here also. It should be bhedad dvividha. Dakara should be double there. So, hamsa, paramhamsa, these are the bhedas in sannyasas. Who is a sannyasi? Sarva karma parityagi. Sarva karma sanga parityagi. Here it can be, a can be there. I'm sorry, asanga. So, asanga parityagi. So, it is not a typo. You can read as a, not a. So, vidhina sarva karma asamantat sanga. Not only sanga. Asanga has been mentioned. So it has further diluted. Sannyasi definition has been diluted. But what has been said? Vidhina. So when you say vidhi, what is this vidhi? Sannyasa vidhi is needs homa also. It is not just dropping karma. So vidhi purvaka. So if you add vidhina, then it is not diluted. If you look at asanga parityagi, Sangha is attachment. Asanga is craving kind of attachment, yearning for it. Giving that up, meaning living a simple life with attachment also is fine. That can person can be called as sannyasi. That will be the meaning if you drop vidhina. But vidhi brings it. What is the vidhi? Vidhi can be only from shastras. So sannyasa vidhina sannyasa. Such a hamsa paramhamsa bhedat dvividha. There are two types, hamsa and paramhamsa sannyasa. Tivra vairagya yuktah hamsa sannyasa kutichaka bahudaka bhedena dviprakaraha. Even the hamsas are of two types, kutichaka and bahudaka. Tirtha tanashaktah kutichakah. One who goes to tirtha, one who does not go to tirthas, stays at one place, is a kutichaka sannyasi. Tirthatana samartha, one who is capable of doing it and goes along, is bahudaka sannyasi, hamsa sannyasi. Paramhamsa sannyasopi vividisha sannyasa vidvat sannyasascha iti dviprakara. Whereas paramhamsa sannyasa is also divided to two. Vividisha meaning veditumicha, being there, one who does not know atma, one who does not have brahmajnana, takes sannyasa for brahmajnana, follows shravana mana nidhyasana. Whereas the other is yajnavalkya category, where jnana is already there. So vidvat sannyasa is when jnana is there, brahmajnana is there, but for nididhyasana, for jivan mukta ananda, one gives up everything and takes sannyasa. Prajnanotpatteer vishaya dosha drushtya tivratara vairagyena jijnyasuna kriyamana sannyasu vividisha sannyasaha. ज्ञानानंतरं दोषदृष्ट्या मिथ्यात्वादि दृढ़ निश्चयेन तीव्रतर वैराग्येण च द्विदुषा क्रियमाण सन्यास विद्वत् सन्यास. वी सॉ द मीनिंग डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन टू. बोथ हैव वैराग्य. वन इज प्री ज्ञान, द अदर इज पोस्ट ज्ञान. विद्वत् सन्यास आदि लक्षणं तु नारद परिव्राजक उपनिषत्सु विद्वत् सन्यास आदि लक्षणं, द डेफिनेशन ऑफ विद्वत् सन्यास, वेयर शुड यू लुक एट मोर डिटेल्स. नारद परिव्राजक उपनिषत् सूत संहितादु द्रष्टव्यम्. सो दीज आर डिस्कस्ड इन नारद परिव्राजक उपनिषत् कॉल्ड एज परिव्राजक मीन्स सन्यासी, देयरफॉर सन्यास उपनिषत् एंड सूत संहिता. सूत संहिता इज दैट विच वाज रेड बाय भगवान भाष्यकार बिफोर राइटिंग दी भाष्य 8 times. इट इज सेड 8 times ही स्टडीड सूत संहिता एंड देन ही रोट भाष्य. Okay, so what about Vamadeva? Now back to Mula. Vamadevadi prarabdham swalpa bhoga hetur asit. Even lesser bhoga, prarabdha bhoga was due for Vamadeva. Ataha tesham Vamadeva ityadi. Others are also Shukamuni ityadi. Ataha tesham sada aruchyutpatter bhogeshu pravrutteva nabhut. Always there was aruchi towards every bhoga, therefore pravritti itself did not take place. They never indulged. Shikidhvajasya jnanarantam rajyanishu adhika pravritti kachyate vasishte. So there is one Shikidhvaja talked about in Yoga Vasishta. So he started having more and more pravritti even after jnana. Ittham jnaninam nana prakara vilakshana vyavahara katita. So vyavahara katita, many types of your nana prakara vilakshana, they need not be same. There are various types of behavior based on various types of prarabdhas due to various types of jnanis. Sarvesham api tesham samamiva jnanam. Jnana does not vary, jnani varies because antakkarana varies, prarabdha varies. Phalam api moksha rupam samanamiva moksha. Phala is definite and is same for all because jnana is same. However, bhoga is different. Vyavaharasu prarabdha bheda nana prakaraha. Therefore, the vyavahara, because the prarabdha is a phala which can come about only by a particular karma, therefore the circumstances being different, karma will also be different across jnanis because prarabdha bhoga due is nana. Vyavahara lopa jivan mukti sukham adhikriyate. Then when vyavahara lopa takes place, one ceases from vyavahara, there is nivritti, there will be jivan mukti ananda because there will always ज्ञान विच इज बैकिंग व्यवहारादिके जीवन मुक्ति सुखम न्यूनताम व्रजेत हाउएवर व्हेन देयर इज प्रवृत्ति वन एक्ट्स आउट द कर्म knowingly also that this is due in prarabdha, still what will happen? There will be lesser jivan mukti sukha. This is also in the case of punya janya bhoga, where there is bhoga due, which will give you sukha, but it will all be vishaya sukha. One may be wanting paramananda sukha, but still vishaya sukha adhikya may be there in prarabdha. Jnani may not prefer it, but still प्रारब्ध भोगा इज देयर ज्ञानिनः विदेह मोक्ष त्याग परलोके इच्छा च न जायते वी लुक एट दिस इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ 485th आवर्त सुकन्यत्यम सप्रकाशम व्यापकं नामूर्पे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धे दृक्यत्व निर्मलं पारं सर्व वेदांत वेद मत्तो निति मे निश्चितामतिः नमस्ते.